everyone, how are you doing? I hope you had a wonderful time in the sunshine last weekend. Wasn't it a lovely little reminder that we're coming out of the winter? I love watching everything waking up, from the blackbirds hopping around on our lawn to the bluebells throwing up their glossy green leaves. Spring is certainly on its way. And I'm sure lots of you are feeling a bit of anticipation about going back to school tomorrow too. Or maybe if you've been at school for the past while, you're looking forward to having some more friends join you in your classroom. If you're feeling a little bit nervous about things changing again, then don't forget what Tim talked to us about a few weeks ago. He reminded us that God is our shield, and that when we feel a bit worried about things, the best thing we can do is ask God to be our protector and to exchange our worries for his perfect peace. I wonder which other characteristics of God are going to be helpful to us as we adjust to new routines again. Actually, I think knowing who God is the best thing to help us to be confident when things are changing. Because when you know that you're loved and precious, that God is your loving Father who loves to give good gifts to his children, that he is faithful to his promises to you, that he's a solid rock to stand on, then somehow the challenges you're facing seem much more manageable and much less dramatic, because you know that God is by your side. If it would help you to think about some of those aspects of God's nature again, or if you missed any of them, don't forget that you can pop to our YouTube channel and find all of our videos to watch at any time. Today, Ruth is going to talk to us about how God is sovereign. That's a tricky word, isn't it? Ruth will explain exactly what that means in a moment if you're not too sure. But first, it's time to worship God with a song. Do you remember this song that we learnt last year called Nothing is Impossible? It's all about how our God is capable of everything. He is above all things. Everything is within his power. Last week we talked about how when we give God glory for who he is, his presence with us increases. So as we sing this song this morning, let's give God glory that nothing is impossible for him and that he is an awesome God.
1, 2, 3, 4. Through you, I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. I'm not gonna live by what I see. I'm not gonna live by what I feel. Deep down I know that you're here with me. I know that you can do anything. Through you I can do impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. I'm not gonna live by what I see. I'm not gonna live by what I feel. Deep down I know that you're here with me. I know that you can do anything. Impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, I believe in you. I believe, I believe in you. I believe, I believe in you. 'Cause I believe. I can do anything, I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible to you. Blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible.
Today, we're thinking about how God is sovereign. I don't use that word very often. It's pretty difficult to spell. I know. When this is finished, you should test your parents or a grown-up and see if they can spell it. God is sovereign. Do you know what that means? It means that God rules over everything. If you take the S off at the front of the word, you get this, sovereign, sovereign, sovereign. It's not the kind of rain which you get, well, we've had a lot of this week. It's the word reigns, like a king reigns. You have to obey a king, don't you? If you don't, you could be thrown into prison or, back in the day, get your head chopped off. God is greater than anything you can imagine. And he rules over it all. And you know what? He created you and he made me. And he cares about us, even though we're so tiny in comparison to all of his creation. Abraham was very rich. He had lots of silver and lots of sheep and other family animals. He could probably buy anything that he wanted. But the one thing that he and Sarah really, really wanted, they couldn't have any children. When Abram was 99, yes, I know, God spoke to him again and gave him a picture. God made Abram look up at the stars. There were zillions of them, just like in this picture. He told Abram that he would have as many children as there are stars in the sky, so long as he obeyed him. Do you know what? He even changed his name. Abram, if you remember, meant honoured father. Well, now he would be known as Abraham, which means father of many. Remember how old Abraham was? That's right, 99. Well, Sarah was about 90 years old, far too old to have a baby. They must have thought God was crackers. Well, they didn't say that, but they did laugh a lot. Abraham knew that God was sovereign, very powerful, and totally in control. He even called God Sovereign Lord. And so Abraham obeyed him. And God forgave Abraham his laughter. When the baby came, he was called Isaac, which means he laughs. You may know the story of how God tested Abraham when Isaac was a young lad. He asked Abraham to kill his much-loved son. Well, Abraham obeyed his sovereign Lord, but it all turned out right in the end. Isaac grew up to have children of his own, and his son had children, and their sons had children. And by the time that Moses was born, it was said that there were as many children as there were stars in the sky. Yes, God keeps his promises. God is bigger than anything we can think of, but he loved a little old man like Abraham to bits. and Abraham learned to love him and obey him too. Do you know what? God loves you and me, and he has a plan for each one of us. I'm going to say a prayer now to finish. So close your eyes again, and thank you for listening so well. You are brilliant. Lord God, sovereign Lord, thank you for all the great things you do. Thank you for being a friend to Abraham and Sarah. It was very hard for them to obey you, but they did it. Send us your Holy Spirit to help us obey you and listen to you. Amen.
Thanks, Ruth. That's such a reassuring thing to know, isn't it? That even though God is sovereign and he rules over all things, still he knows and loves each of us completely, and he's our best friend. Let's spend a few minutes again this morning allowing the Holy Spirit to remind us of who God is, that although he's powerful and sovereign, he is closer to us than we can possibly imagine. Whether you're feeling excited or a bit unsteady about going to school tomorrow, isn't it good to know that God is by your side and that he loves you more than the depths of the sea or the heights of the tallest mountains?
God spoke to Abraham and made promises to him. They might have seemed like they were impossible promises, but nothing is impossible for God. Abraham knew God's voice. He was familiar with it, and he trusted and obeyed God. This morning, we're going to give the Holy Spirit space to speak to us. It might not be words that you hear. It might be that God gives you a picture or reminds you about something we've talked about together. Or he might simply give you a sense of his peace in exchange for something that you felt worried about.
So let's close our eyes and give God all of our attention. Heavenly Father, thank you that you are so close to us, and yet you are powerful and sovereign over all things at the same time. We pray that you would help us to trust your promises and to recognize your voice when you speak to us. Come, Holy Spirit. Don't forget that you can pause this video to chat with your family about anything you've heard from God and to take some time together to pray. Maybe God's given you a picture or you've really experienced his presence this morning. And if that's the case, you definitely don't want to rush on from this moment too quickly. You can take as long on this section as you like. No time with God is ever wasted. That's almost it from us for today. Suzanne has put together some colouring, a word search and a craft focused around the story of Abraham. We've emailed them to your grown-up, so make sure to check them out, and we hope you have lots of fun doing those. If you'd like to get in touch, my email address is jules@stphilipstjames.org. The kids team are always delighted to hear from you, and we'd especially love to know if there's anything that you'd like us to be praying for you. Have a great week, keep safe, and we'll see you again soon.